Good morning, class. Now we are going to start the new lesson, lesson number 5, advanced features in MS Access. Lesson number 5, advanced features in MS Access. In this chapter we'll discuss some topics. So before this I'm going to tell you, in the previous lesson already we have discussed how we can create a database and how we can apply some feature on the database. Already we have discussed to hide the columns, rows, okay, rename the fields and freeze, unfreeze, okay, all the operation we have performed already on the database. So now we are going to learn some new features which will perform on the database, and after that we can make our database more attractive and more useful, right? So in this lesson number 5, advanced feature in MS Access, in this lesson we will discuss some topics. The first topic is a master table concept. Master table concept, that means using a master table concept we can change our data in a different location. Suppose that you have a one table, that is a master database, and after that the some information we want to access at another place. So there is no need to make another table, right? So using the master table we can access that table or some information from the table, right? Example, in a school there is a many department, computer department, science department, and there is also, we can say, a hostel also, and we have a one master table in our office. So the same table student information we can access at different location using the master table concept. And the next topic is the second is a searching in a database. So in a database, if we want to search any information, suppose that we want to search student's name, student DOB, or suppose that a contact number, right? So in that case, in a database we can use a search option, right? Already we have discussed on navigation bar. Using that navigation bar we can move or we can jump at any location, any record, right? But the search option, using the searching option we can search any particular information, student name, DOB, contact number, and etc. After that we can do some modification if you want to change, and if you want to change or delete, then you can do, right? Now next topic is calculation in a data sink, right? In a database we can create a table, and after that if we want to do calculations, suppose that we are making any types of salary details or any types of inventory detail, and after that we want to calculate the values, right? So all types of operation we can perform, right? So there is a calculation, we can perform calculation in a sheet also, fine. Now the next topic is of filtering, and this is a very important feature in MS Access, because using the filter option we can see our filter record. Like suppose that I have a many information in a database, and after that I want to find out the only one section students. In a one database there is a section A, B, C, D, okay? So after that I want to see the only those records the students belongs to section A. So using the filter option we can filter the data from the table, and we can see the filtered record, okay? And now next is also the advanced feature, advanced filter option. We can use two types of filter, either simple filter, and the next is advanced filter. So using the advanced filter we can apply the criteria condition. Using the criteria condition we can filter the data in a data sheet. How will do this filter option on the system on a database? All the operation will do as a practical section in next class. Next topic is a sorting, right? And the sorting is also the very important feature in our Access, because it is used to sort the data in the ascending, either ascending or descending order, right? Suppose that I want to see all the information in ascending order, right? A to Z format. So we can use the sorting option, or if we want to see the data in the descending order, Z to A, so we can use the sorting option, or we can apply the sorting option on the value also. If we want to see the data numbers from min to max, right? So we can use the sorting option, or if we want to see the data from max to min, right? So we can apply the sorting option on the database. So this is also very important feature in Access, because we type the value, we type the record in a database, in a table, it's in any form. There is no ascending or descending concept, right? And after that, we can sort the data, right? And we can use the sorting option ascending to descending, A to Z concept, right? And also we use the Z to A concept. So using the ascending or descending feature, we can sort our data in our database. Importing data from another application. And this is the last topic we'll discuss in this chapter. And this is a very important topic in MS Access, because sometimes we want to import a data. And why we use this feature? Because the same data we have already in another application, like suppose that in MS Access, and the same data we want in MS Access. So there is no need to create a table or database in MS Access. We can import Excel file in MS Access, right? So using the import data from another application feature, using this feature we can import any Excel file from any another application to MS Access. Okay, so this is a very important feature. How will you do on the system? All the topics we'll discuss in one by one, from master data to importing data, right? So all the practical topic we'll discuss one by one in next class. How we can apply all the feature, right? Like master table concept, searching in a database, any types of information we can search, any types of detail we can search in a database, calculations in a data sheet, how we can perform the calculation, how we can perform operation like addition, subtractions. Okay, so all types of operation we can do in our data sheet, like a filtering in our data sheet. So there are records and we want to filter any types of information in our data sheet. We do advanced filter. So how we'll perform the advanced feature filter option in our data sheet? Okay, we'll discuss. And the sorting feature also, how we can sort our data as either ascending or descending, right? So using the sorting feature, we can perform this option. And the last topic, importing data from another application, right? So how we can import data from Excel file into database. So these all topics we'll discuss in the next class, one by one, right?